All right, today we're tuning this 2015 F-150 FX4 Ecoboost truck. It has a different center section in the turbochargers. Other than that, it appears to be stock. So we don't do a lot of these, so curious to see how it's going to work out, what kind of power to expect. Should be a good one. Alright, like I said in the beginning there, really isn't much done to this truck, so the engine bay is really not that wild looking, but supposedly he lost a turbocharger and he put a new center section in it, so it's got a little bit different compressor wheel. I don't know if I drive one of these, daily drive one of these, but mine's a 13, so it's still a steel body truck. But man, these things look good, I really like them. But obviously it's filthy dirty, there's really not much we can do about that. The roads this time of year up here are horrible, which is why I end up working on a bunch of, you know, stuff like this, these trucks and that kind of thing. But yeah, this is just a nice truck. Like I said, I don't do a lot of EcoBoost stuff. Interior in these things are great. Mine, you can put so much stuff in the back seat and be super comfortable. They're definitely a nice truck to own. I like it. And my personal truck, I had tuned that one time a few years back. I maxed the fuel system out in a couple hits and pretty much called it a day at that. So I'm curious to see what this thing's gonna make. I'll work around a couple of the different airflow issues related to the larger or the different turbocharger. I know this has got a wastegate, which he preset. And he believes it's set too high. It's throwing an overboost code currently, so I gotta work around that. That does mean that we won't get a very good baseline from it, because I can't complete a pull as it sits. But I'm gonna dive into this thing and see what we can make. I'm really hoping to see some good numbers out of this, so check it out. Alright, just got wrapped up with that 2016 F-150, made 404 foot-pounds of torque, 347 horsepower. Check the graph out. These graphs are a little bit choppy. I have the smoothing all turned off on this, but the ECU is doing so much to control load that it's a little all over the place. It uses ignition timing, fuel corrections, throttle blade opening, and boost control, all of those to control load. So. Again, I don't do a ton of these, but 404 foot-pounds of torque and 350 horsepower, I'm assuming that's a pretty decent number on only 87 octane fuel. We were a bit knock limited. I actually had to turn it down a little bit. At one point, we made 420 foot-pounds of torque, but it was just a little aggressive for 87 octane. So would have been cool to do one on 93 and see what it would have made, but still nonetheless very happy with it. Gonna leave it like that, and for a daily driver style truck, can't complain, especially being that it's basically stock with a turbocharger upgrade. I don't know how much different the turbocharger is. I know it's just a CHRA change, so it's the same turbine housing, same compressor housing, same wastegate actuators, so it can't be a ton different, obviously. But yeah, so that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and check out the videos. We're going to keep posting these, so subscribe and follow along. Thanks.